Hello, everybody. Steve here. It's late tonight. Finally, everyone's asleep, so I can do a small video. I've got a small project going on, and I figured I'd do a video about it. Don't have any knives on the way or anything, so figured why not. One thing, and this is what's leading to the video, was that somebody noticed that in a video I did, I forget which one, they saw a Sun Spark Station in the video on my desk. And well, I have to prepare you. I have a very messy desk. I do have a Sun Spark Station here. Right there. That is a Sun Spark Station 20. It's got two 85 megahertz processors. It's got two 4.2 gigabyte hard drives. It's a good little machine. I've had it for a long time. And I mean, it's pretty old anyway. I've had it for 10 years myself. And I have no idea when they started bringing them out. Never researched it, but I have a software project that I've been working on, and it's more of a, you know, can you do it type of project. I haven't written software in a long time, so what I've got is dhcp, basically. Like, I have a wireless network going on, right? And if someone ever managed to break my WPA2 encryption, I imagine they'd probably be able to get an IP. So what I figured I'd do is I'd have a separate DHCP server on a computer, and then I wrote an actual piece of software that will let me connect to it from anywhere that can connect to that computer, and then I can list the leases right out of the lease file. Now, right now, that computer down there, that Dell server, is running DHCP and the program that I wrote. And it's a dual P3 1.4 gigahertz machine. And that's all it's doing. I mean, once in a while I might process a video on it, but other than that, it's sitting there on, and it's, I think, I'm not certain, but I think it's wasting a lot of power. And now, as you know, I don't have the most money in the world, so I've been trying to cut back. So what I was thinking is that I would like to keep my system going, and I was thinking maybe I could use that Sun there. Now, what I've done so far, you can see I spliced my multimeter into the power cable. Now, it's not on right now. Suppose I could turn it on. Let's check this out here. Turn on the... Oh, yeah, I got the power bar turned off too. Okay. So you can see the multimeter is on. Now, I've already done this, so I know that like this machine here, I mean, obviously it has the 20 amp setting, and it has the amp setting, and the amp setting is for 2 amps, so, or less. So I can tell you that's pulling, I'd say, an average of about 40 milliamps. Nothing major, that's just off. Now, turn it on here, and it goes up. As you can see, it's, you know, pulling out 770 milliamps. What it can tell you is, at idle, this machine is net booted right now, and the computer that actually hosts the NFS server and all the junk for it is not on, so it's not actually going to get all the way to the operating system. But at idle, it sits around 900 milliamps, so just under 1 amp. Now, I mean, the power supply here is 115 volts approximately, so I worked it out, 720 hours in a 30-day period, if it was running 24/7, and DHCP doesn't require really any resources, and neither does my, neither does the software I wrote. So, I mean, it's just going to be idling. So I worked it out, to it. It works out to about $4.74 per month in hydro, running that. And that's basically as far as I've gotten so far. I haven't really had time. What I want to do now is plug it into my server here and see what kind of juice it runs at idle as well. Now I also want to test 100% power, because or at least 50. Both those machines are dual processor. I did have a race condition in the software I wrote that I've since fixed, but basically when it occurred, processor usage went 100%, but it only went to 100% in one processor, so it wasn't huge, but I fixed that. But there is the possibility, if something goes wrong, that all of a sudden I'm using full processor. So my reasoning, why thinking that Sun is probably more efficient than the Dell over here, is because the power supply in that Sun is only 150 watts, and I think that Dell power supply is like 300 or more. So I mean, I'm certain that the Sun engineers engineered that thing to not actually come up to that 150 watts, so I'm sure it's going to be less. Right now, that machine uses, at idle, 107 watts or 103 watts or something like that. So, it's never going to go above 150, where if that one could easily go above 150, and I'd rather not find that out, because I might not log into that server for, a couple of weeks, and, I go in there, check it out, and find out it's been running at 100% for, who knows how long, right? And then watch the power bill skyrocket. So, anyway, that's the project I'm currently working on. Be curious to know if you have any comments or questions or anything. Flames, whatever. Doesn't really matter to me. Just screwing around in my basement, basically. Because I can't sleep. And I got, see my time, my whole family's in bed, so I time to myself. So, yeah, I think actually I'm going to stay up and work on this a little bit. Reorganize some stuff. I've got some other computers here. Might as well do that too. I've got a Compaq server here. It's got a tape drive that I have no tapes for, and I have no desire to get tapes for. 2.2 gigahertz. What's it got in there? I forget what it's got in there. Then I got my Dell down here. As I said before, dual 1.4 gigahertz processors. P3s. It's got three SCSI drives, 18.3 gigs each. Two of them are rated together. One is a boot drive. I didn't feel like setting it up to boot off the RAID drive. I was kind of bored. I have a second one. I don't know if you can see it. It doesn't look very good through the viewfinder, but it's pretty much the same as the other one over there. It's got the same loadout, minus the hard drives. And it's really a parts machine, because, it's missing a heatsink, and I'm not going to buy one. And here is my newest desktop, if you call an Athlon 2000 XP new, 1.6 gigahertz. Can't really tell from there, but it's got a case with the cutout in the side, and you can see all the components and stuff. It was cool back in the day when I built it. Not anymore. It's got Windows XP on it. And to be honest with you, I rarely ever use it, because I rarely ever come down here anymore, which is kind of sad, actually. But, And then, of course, I got my Genesis Model 1 on top of my Sun there with my flat screen. So, it's pretty much it for the desk there. I got a printer no one cares about. 21-inch CRT tube that, ancient technology. So, I got some stuff down here. So, stuff to keep me busy. I like working with electronics and stuff, too. So, I've got a whole pile of stuff there. Projects I like to work on, someday soon, when I collect enough parts, I'd like to build a small, like sort of a windmill wind generator. I have motors, I have you know, everything I need. I just need to actually build the part that collects the wind. I have some ideas that I'd like to try out. So, gonna do that in the future. So I guess you can call this sort of a project update or account update. I'll post another video if there's any interest on it. It's past midnight here, so I hope you had having a good day or a good night. Hope you're having a good night's sleep anyway, because I'm definitely not. So hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Take care.